Hey guys, welcome to the Skolo Online YouTube channel, the channel that is all about learning. In this channel, I make a lot of videos on how to create your own website, how to create your own e-commerce or WooCommerce website and start making money online by selling products online. If you're new to this channel, please remember to hit the subscribe button. You can find it at the bottom of the video and just hit subscribe. Please like this video if you like my content and remember to leave me a comment below. Talk to me, let me know what you like about the videos, what you don't like about the videos, what I can do to improve on these videos. And if you're new to the channel as well, if you go to the description, there is video timestamps available for you. If you want to jump ahead to certain sections of the video, if you don't want to watch the entire video, please feel free to utilize those video timestamps and follow us on our social media channels. We've got a Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram page, and let's start learning. In this video, I'm going to be taking you through the process of writing Python code for automating sending SMS messages. So this is a code that would be useful if you wanted to build a messaging platform. And actually, there's a lot of requirements I come across these days where people are asking, can you send me bulk messages? Can you send me a service can you sell me a service for this and that? And people charge a whole lot of money for this, and it's not as complicated as it looks, because nowadays you don't have to actually write the SMS code yourself, because that's the alternative, is buy a SIM card and write the code for the SMSing yourself, which if you want us to go through at some point, we can do that. But it's a long process and it's got a lot of boilerplate coding in there. And at the end of the day, the cost of sending that SMS, I've done the math, ends up being pretty much the same as just using a pre-packaged solution like Twilio. So today I'm going to show you how to do this using Twilio. So Twilio is a library that is in all the major programming languages, whether you're using Python, using Ruby, or using JavaScript, whatever you're programming in, you can find the library or the SDK for that. And we're going to do this using a Python. So just go over to Google and just search for Twilio, and I think it's the first one that comes up, and I've just opened a window here and I'm just going to take you through this. So what Twilio is that they built this platform where they've already written the SDKs to allow you to with like two or three lines of code send automated SMSs, and they will provide you with a phone number to use, which is one of the numbers that they would already have secured, one of their own SIM cards. So the other way of doing this, if you want to really get down and dirty, is to buy your own SIM card and put your SIM card into a 3G sort of reader and code that using like a Raspberry Pi. I mean, it's like a long process, and I can do that, and I've done that before, because I was just learning. But it's a long process to do that. It'll take you tons and tons and lines of code, but you still have to buy data for that SMS. You still have to buy airtime for that SMS. So one way or the other, it's going to cost you something. And I found that amount of money you spent to buy the airtime for that SMS, actually, in some cases, it's cheaper to pay the Twilio amount, because Twilio, they do this in bulk and they benefit from bulk messaging, so it actually costs you less. So it doesn't make sense to try and do this the hardcore way. You can just do this the simple way with Twilio. So go on to Twilio and sign up. By the way, there's no affiliation links here, guys. I'm not affiliated with Twilio. I don't have an affiliation code. I'm not getting a cent for this. I'm just showing you pretty much the most effective and efficient way of doing this if you wanted to program SMSs. So go to their website, twilio.com, and click on sign up, right? And there's two things you need from Twilio to be able to write your code. On the other screen, I've already written some lines of code here. So let me just like put this all the way at the bottom so that you don't look at that. So just focus on this. There is three things actually that you need from Twilio, okay? To open your Twilio account, you need to get they'll give you an SID, they'll give you a token, and then you need to purchase a phone number. Okay, and once you purchase a phone number, then you're going to enter the phone number there, and inside your phone number, you're going to need some sort of airtime, maybe a dollar. It's not really a lot. It costs like fractions, like cents to send an SMS. But you're going to need all of this. This is why we're creating the account. So once you get there, you click on sign up. And I've opened that already. So let's just sign up here with our Skolo. Okay, so they have sent me a verification email on my email address. So I need to go over there and click on that link. So I'm going to do that quickly and then we'll continue with the video. Okay, so I've verified my email address. You can see over there after clicking on it. The next thing you need to do is just enter a phone number. And let's see, what do they need to verify a number? More secure and user testing products during the trial. You can also use these numbers, caller ID when making outbound phone calls. Okay, fine. So let's put in a phone number in there. Yay. So once all of that is done, I'll go through the questionnaire. I want to use SMS. Okay. I want to build alerts and notifications. I'm going to do this with code. And let's continue. My preferred coding language in this specific case is going to be Python. And I don't know how to host my code on Twilio, but you can do that, hey. But so for now, let's use our own hosting service. We already bought a VPS for this purpose, so we're not going to host the code there. And then just like that, you have your Twilio startup. So this is what I was talking about. You need an SID. You need a token, okay? And then you need a trial number. So let's just click there and see what the trial number that it is that we're going to be given. All right. So your first Twilio phone number. Okay. Boom, boom, boom. You can use a different one if you don't like, but this will work for voice, SMS, and MMS. So let's choose this number. All right. So this is the new phone number. Let's just copy it as it is there. Copy it there and say done. All right, so that's the same number over there. So we need to go and find where our Python code is because we're going to need that phone number. Right. All right, so enter your Twilio phone number. That's over there. So this is the phone number that we need. You enter that in there that we just received. All right, and then we need to come up here and we need to have a look at the SID and the token. So let us copy the SID, all right, and put the SID in there. All right, and let's copy the token as well. And we have the token over there. So this is all we need. This is all we need to get started with a Twilio. All right, so you've got the token, you've got the SID, and you've got the a phone number and simple lines of code. You import twilio-rest, you input all of this, create the client object, and then you start, you can send your first SMS, okay? So let me just put up the lines of code that I've written there and take you through the lines of code. All right, so forget about that list of numbers. We'll get back to that later. This is the code over here for writing just one SMS to a person, okay? Send one SMS. And we're going to input the phone number that we're sending the SMS to, okay? The client is the one that we initiated up here, messages with the SID and the token. So the client messages create a message, and you're going to put in the body of your message there, all right? So maybe let's type in here our first SMS message from Twilio, all right? And then from Twilio phone, the message comes from Twilio phone. Yes, that's the variable over there. So that will go in there. And sendTo is the sendTo that you've entered at the top of the function. So if you wrote this function like this, so let's actually like put this at the bottom. Actually, let's put this as well at the bottom because we're not currently using this. Okay, so we don't have to look at that for now. So this is all you need, okay? We've written a function to send one message, and that function is client messages create. That's the message, the phone number sent to. And then you call that function over there and you enter the phone number, which is the phone number that we passed over there to send that message to. You can test this. I promise you it'll work. Let me see if I can test this. Let me see where's my VPS. All right. So yeah, let's test this. Why not? So I'm going to I'm going to create a new Python file in here, and I'm going to call it nano sms.py, like that. And then once that open, I'm going to just copy all of this in there. Right. The first thing, from needs an underscore after it, okay? So from, make sure you have an underscore after the from, okay? And then because we need only one closing bracket, okay? So from the body, a client messages create, this is what the body is, from and to, send to the SMS, okay? So let's close this, yes, and run it. Python sms.py. There you go. SMS sent successfully. I'm going to look at my phone in front of me here, and I'm going to check that the SMS has been sent. You won't be able to see it on your side, but I will let you know if I've received it. And I have received it. Sent from your Twilio trial account. Our first SMS message from Twilio. So when you're using the trial, each and every single SMS that comes across will start with the words send from your Twilio trial account, okay? But then you can always get a proper account and get rid of the trial account by paying for an actual phone number and for the data. And I assure you, it's not that expensive. It's definitely cheaper than even if you had to buy the airtime yourself. All right, so send one message, that's done. I just wanted to show you lines in case you wanted to send multiple messages. Let's say you had, 20, 50 different phone numbers you wanted to send SMSs to, because why would you write a whole Python code just to send one SMS, okay? So let's say you have, you're trying to send marketing messages to 50 employees, 50 SMSs at the same time. You would create a list with all their numbers, whether it's 50 or 100 numbers. So you'd have a list of numbers like that. Once you create a list of numbers like that, you already have a function for sending one SMS that you've already tested. This function works, okay? Once you've done that, you would write a function like this, okay? Function send to all, and then you would include your list of numbers, which is that list. This list can be as long or as short as you want it to be. Then you would say for number in a list of numbers. So this will iterate through all the numbers, send the message with a number. So it will iterate through all these numbers over here, and it will then call this function, and then inside this function, you will enter the number that you want to send to. So send to all, for number in numbers, send one message and number. And then after that, you would then just call the send to all function and input in there your list of numbers. And that's how you can send a bulk SMSs to 50, to 100, to 1,000 people. Okay, so this is good for marketing people. So instead of, before you go hire some marketing company that's going to charge you, I don't know how much per bulk SMSs, write your own Python code and pay the minimal amount. Because those guys are using the exact same lines of code that I'm just showing to you. Okay. Thank you guys for watching. See you next time.